Empowered for Exploits, Part 2. In Empowered for Exploits, Part 1, we noted that holiness is an exploit that every Christian is expected to perform, but which the enemy of our soul does not want to see us achieve. We also discussed some of the instruments the enemy uses to try to stop us from living a holy life. Genesis chapter 6, verse 5 tells us that God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. However, we are told in Genesis 5:24 that Enoch walked with God and God took him. In other words, even though Enoch lived in a world that was full of wickedness, iniquity, darkness and so on, he chose to be on God's side. And Enoch was not the only one. Genesis 6:9, these are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations. And Noah walked with God. Job chapter 1 verse 1. There was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job. And that man was perfect and upright, and one that feared God and eschewed evil. Job chapter 1 verse 8. And the Lord said unto Satan, Hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feared God and eschewed evil? Luke chapter 1 verses 5 and 6. There was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zechariah of the court of Abia, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. These are just a few examples of people in the Bible whose lives show that it is actually possible to perform the exploit of holiness in a world of sin. To be able to do the exploit, you must recognize that it is mandatory for anyone who wants to make it to heaven. Hebrews 12:14 tells us that without holiness, no one will see the Lord. You should also be willing to perform the exploit. Recognize that there are challenges on the way to living a life of perfection. Recognizing these challenges makes you watch out for them and also get yourself prepared to face and subdue them whenever they arise. However, you must be truly determined to overcome and win. Do not forget to add aggression to your determination, because Satan and his cohorts do not give up easily. If you are serious about living a holy life, do not make anyone but Jesus your role model. Hebrews 12:2 says that we should fix our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer of our faith, who will also make it perfect. Some people have missed their way to heaven because they were paying too much attention to one person or the other that they thought should be up there. Some have either gone back to the world or relaxed on the issue of holiness because their pastor, whom they thought was an epitome of righteousness, was discovered to be living an immoral life. Get into the Word of God and keep your eyes focused on Jesus till the end. Also, do not let anyone convince you that being holy is impossible. We have seen a few examples of people recorded in the Bible who were living right in a sinful world. There are also Christians today who are determined that they will not be defeated by the world, the flesh, or the devil. Mark chapter 10 verses 26 and 27, and they were astonished out of measure, saying among themselves, who then can be saved? And Jesus, looking upon them, said, with men it is impossible, but not with God, for with God all things are possible. You should not depend on the arm of flesh, because your flesh is working for the enemy and will fail you. The power to live a holy life does not come from church ordination. Therefore, if you have been seeking church ordination in the hope that it will automatically make you holy, you can as well stop. Many church ordained ministers are living in sin and will go to hell if they fail to repent and amend their ways before they meet the Lord. There are people who pride themselves in being members of one particular church or the other. Note again that the church you attend does not make you righteous, nor does the fact that you have been in the church for a long time. It is possible to attend the best church, if indeed there is any such thing, and still go around with a garment stained with sin. If you truly want the power to live holy, turn to the Holy Spirit. He is the one that empowered those who did the exploits recorded in the scripture. For instance, Luke chapter 1, 34 and 35 say, Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Acts 1:8, But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Acts 2:4, And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. 1 Kings 18:46, And the son Elijah, and he gathered up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. If you want to be empowered to live a holy life in this present world and in this end time, cry out to God for an infilling of His Holy Spirit, the Spirit of power. You should also get in the Word and stay in constant communication with the Lord through prayer. May the Lord empower every one of us in Jesus' name.